Hi guys, welcome back to Money Monday. This video is all about how to manage your cash flow and your budget. If you are really serious about improving your financial situation, achieving your financial goals and dreams, you have got to master the art of managing your cash flow and your budget. You need to be able to prepare for all upcoming expenses and be completely informed. You've also got to be able to handle any unexpected curveballs that life may throw you, such as, you know, a white good breaking down or a car needing to be replaced, or an unexpected medical bill. Things like this happen to all of us and they're just a natural part of life, but you need to be prepared for that so that when this happens, you're not thrown into the financial fetal position that some of us do, where we have to then reach for a credit card and undo all the great work that we've done. We need to be prepared for these so that we can quickly get back on our feet again financially and continue on moving towards achieving our goals and our dreams. So I'm going to be making a series of videos for different people in different situations as to how to best manage your cash flow and your budget. I'll be doing videos on for people who are self-employed and on freelancing work who have an irregular flow of money and how to manage that cash flow. I'll be doing a video for families on how to manage the cash flow and budget because that can be particularly hard with growing children, hungry tummies, and kids that grow out of clothes and toys all the time. It's particularly challenging. I'm also going to be doing a video on how to manage your cash flow for people who are retired, and do a video for people managing their cash flow for students. So if you haven't already, please make sure you subscribe to my channel. Now, to get this video started, I'm actually going to focus on people who are freelancing or self-employed, people who earn commissions or bonuses and don't have a set base salary to rely on. So my first step is to do a budget. No matter what you're earning or how much you're earning in the way that you earn money, you need to understand what is your living expenses. Now, I've previously explained, if you subscribe to the Sugar Mama website, not just this YouTube channel, you will get a complimentary Excel spreadsheet, and it's a basic template to help you come up with all your living expenses. I do have an app, which is in the process of almost being finished and will be launched any day now. But for the meantime, this is a great starting place to work out what your total living expenses are. You need to understand what is your total cost of living. Understand your weekly expenses, your monthly expenses, your quarterly expenses, your biannual expenses, your annual expenses. You also need to factor in things like Christmas presents, birthday presents, and holidays. You also need to round everything up so that you can factor in for cost of inflation, rising prices, and for little things that you might forget that will help the buffer cover those things. Step two is to have two separate accounts. One being a receiving account and the other one being your monthly expense account. Now, every time you get paid, no matter how big or how little it is, it always goes into this account. You then transfer a set amount per month into your everyday living account. What you are doing is almost creating a base salary for yourself. You are creating consistency and reliability. If there are months, for example, where you might earn a big bonus or a big commission or have a lot of freelancing work, you are actually removing that false sense of security where you may think, oh wow, I earn all this money this month, I can go and buy all these things. But you are actually forgetting about all the future expenses that are coming up or the fact that you may have a quiet couple of months. But by doing this, you're almost creating yourself on creating your own base salary. And what you do is you have an automatic direct debit of X amount of dollars per month that goes into your everyday living expense. Step three is to regularly review your budget, but also review that budget against your calendar. You need to know about what special events you have coming up, what upcoming bills you've got due, what bills that you previously have that have accumulated that you haven't paid yet. You need to be completely on top of your bills. Ideally, you should pay your bills the moment they are due or the moment that they come in the mail. Now, by creating this consistency and this reliability, for the months where you don't earn as much money or there isn't much work available, because you have been stockpiling and creating this safety net through the incoming account, you are actually creating and building up future month's salary that you can continuously draw that cover you for those quiet months. Having said that though, there may be times where you aren't earning as much or there isn't as much work where you have to really review that budget again and maybe cut some things out or cut some things down. You may need to live frugally for those types of months, but at least by having a budget, you know where to make those cuts and how. Now, there is a third account that I recommend you do, which is not essential, but I do advise it. This account is what I call your life account. This is where you try and put extra money in this account, either through excess funds left over by the end of the month or by paying slightly more out of your regular salary account, and you put this money into the third account. Now, that is to cover those quarterly, biannual, or annual expenses, and particularly things like to help you prepare for those expensive times of the year, such as Christmas time, where you may need to go out and buy a whole pile of presents which you hadn't previously budgeted for. This money should have an additional buffer on top of that that you can slowly build up over time that will cover you for any sort of unexpected expense that I was previously talking about. A classic example for me this month is my washing machine has finally died, my dishwasher is broken, and I've got a couple of problems with my television. So I'm probably up for a good $1,500 to $2,000 in bills this month. And because I've always rounded my expenses up in my budget, it's not going to completely cause a catastrophe in the way that I manage my cash flow. I will survive, it will be a tight month, but it's okay because I'm prepared for that. I've been proactive with my money. Now, this creates a great sense of security and peace of mind, and I don't need to waste too much time and energy stressing or worrying about this expense. And most importantly, I'm not going to be relying on a credit card to help fix the problem. Now, my final tip, and this is optional, but that is to have two more accounts. One being a holiday savings account. Over time, as you get really good at managing your cash flow and you've mastered the art, you feel confident and in control of the way that you manage your money, you're not creating a debt, and you're actually seeing yourself building up a good buffer in your life account, I recommend you have a holiday savings account. Now, this means that as you're working really hard, you have some savings that are building up that you can use to go on a holiday. Now, I've used a holiday as an example, but it might be some other financial lifestyle goal of yours, such as saving up for a car or saving up for a deposit or saving up for some new furniture. Whatever that particular goal is for you, that can be your fourth account. And never turn your nose up at putting a little bit of money into that account. Yes, you may be able to only afford putting $10 or $20 into that savings account, but it doesn't matter. You are heading in the right direction and you're progressing in the right direction, and progression breeds more success and more motivation and more determination, which is only going to compound over time. Now, the other fifth and final savings account that I recommend you have if you want is what I call a saving to invest account. Now, this is extra money that you don't need for any immediate or medium-term expenses, but it's money that you think you would like to do something with it for a rainy day, such as investing and building up long-term passive income. Now, that is where I recommend you put that extra money away until you've decided or know what you want to do with that money. Now, keep that money slowly building up over time, but use that time to build up your own level of financial education and knowledge, so that when you do know what you want to do with that money and where you want to invest it, it's an informed decision. You understand the risks involved, the volatility, and you know that it's going to match your risk profile, but most importantly, it's going to match your financial goal. And as I share with you guys in most of my videos, having a goal to build up long-term passive income streams so that eventually your passive income stream covers your living expenses, which you know because you've done your budget, is a fantastic and realistic goal to have. And also an incredibly exciting goal to have. So remember, at the end of the day, it's about really understanding your cost of living, knowing exactly where your money goes and where it needs to go, and prioritizing those expenses, being really on top of your upcoming expenses, paying those bills when they come in time, and paying for everything in cash so that you really understand and feel what the true cost of living is. Often when we use a payless way of paying, such as through credit card, we don't really acknowledge or respect that expense. And that is how very easily credit card debt can accumulate and blow out and throw us into financial stress. One thing that I can personally promise you is when you do this properly, you will feel really good about yourself. You are showing yourself a sense of self-love, and it will improve your sense of self-worth, which is great for your emotional well-being as well as your financial well-being. Being in control of your money is a great habit to have, and you are going to reap the benefits of it, I promise you. So if you haven't already, please make sure you subscribe. There are so many videos on my channel as to how to save money, how to invest money, how to build wealth, how to save for your first home, whether it's worth renting versus buying. This is the channel for you if you want to really build and improve your financial knowledge so that you can create a better financial future for yourself. Now, talking of budget and cash flow and work, I better go and get myself to work. So I wish you guys a fantastic and productive week, and I will see you later in the week for my lifestyle playlist, Lifestyle Love. Ciao for now.